consider now the sales, applying exactly the same approach just used for the inventory. If you do the computations, you will discover that the 20% of the items determines the 80% of the value of the sales. Based on the tables of both the inventory and the sales, it is possible to derive the so-called ABC inventory sales matrix. Crossing the three classes derived for the inventory with those derived for the sales, 9 categories of items can be identified. The cluster of classes along the main diagonal of the matrix corresponds to the area of consistency. Indeed, it is composed by the AA, BB and CC items for which there is coherence between the value of inventory and the value of the sales. There may be different reasons behind the misalignment between inventories and sales, such as low replenishment frequency, minimum lot imposed by the supplier, low supply reliability, discounts for high quantity lots, inventories supporting the launch of new products, speculation, errors in forecasting the demand, not updated inventory management parameters. From the analysis of the 9 classes, it is possible to get useful indications to improve the inventory management. In particular, let's see the most significant cases which lie at the extremes of the matrix. Let's start from the first case, the AA items, which are characterized by high sales and high inventories. The area is called a tension area, since these items represent both a risk and an opportunity. Indeed, stockouts would cause heavy drops of the turnover, and this class is the one that offers the highest opportunities in terms of inventory reduction in case there is extra inventory which is not needed. The second significant case is the one of the CA items which are characterized by low sales and high inventories. Indeed, the area is called inefficiency area. In this situation, it is not enough to wait until the stocks are used, but it might be necessary to reduce them, for example, stopping the replenishment and the production, or pushing sales through promotions. Third, let's consider the AC items characterized by low inventories and high sales. It is a privileged class of items and it represents a good example of inventory management. However, it can hide some risks. If the inventory level requirements are underestimated, there could be stockouts. The last significant case we see is the one of the CC items, characterized by low sales and low inventories. This class represents the majority of the items managed, reason for which it entails high management costs, both at an information system level, in case of a wide product range, and at a warehouse level, storage cost. ABC Inventory Sales Matrix is a dynamic tool that allows to take different pictures of the inventories of different items over time, study the migration of the items among the different classes, and identify priorities that need situations to focus on. In this lecture, we have seen what is and how to derive an ABC inventory sales matrix, how to find the ABC classes, and which the main areas composing the matrix are.